everyone, my name is Sara Dietschy, rhymes with Peachy. Welcome to another video. We're gonna get a little technical. So this is how to fix your Dell XPS display. Now I'm focusing on this just because traditionally XPS displays have been very vibrant. That is the nice way to put it. And when you're making content for the internet, whether it's YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, most people are viewing your stuff on their phone or maybe other laptop screens, and every display has their own characteristics. So you wanna make sure that you're starting it off right. So this is an example of what we're looking at here. So this is my Dell XPS, basically straight out of the box, super saturated. We're comparing it with my iPhone XR. I mean, most people are gonna be viewing your Instagrams, Twitters, YouTubes on an iPhone, maybe on a Mac, but also all the other billion Android devices, and just, yeah, you wanna get this figured out. I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. This isn't the first time I've tried to film this video.
Flashback. End of flashback.
Calibrators will eventually be involved, but see, Dell has this app called the Dell Premiere Color app, where you can go in and change it to sRGB, Rec 709. It'll allow you to change it to another color space, and it does get less saturated. However, our app wasn't working. Premiere Color just wasn't working. It was just staying super vibrant. When I was at Computex, I was talking to Tom the Tech Chap about this problem, and he was having the same issue. Premiere Color just wasn't changing anything, and now I realize, okay, maybe this is why this thing wasn't working on my XPS. Something was just not right. Well, he actually messaged me and was like, oh my gosh, some update fixed something, and now the Premiere Color app works. So this is a long way to just say, if you haven't tried Dell Premiere Color app, you can download it from the Microsoft Store directly from Dell's website, and that will solve your base level saturation problem. So again, if you're making internet content that lives in this weird box that we're all in, hello, how are you? You need to go for the sRGB color space, just because that's what you do. A little note here, if you're in Dell Premiere and there's no visual change when you're going in between vibrant and sRGB, that means the BIOS update didn't solve the problem, and you're gonna have to actually uninstall your graphics drivers and reinstall them. So an app called DDU will help you do that, and I'll link that in the description below. Troubleshooting, it's fun, right? BIOS update, make sure you're up to date, and then, you know, you're gonna have to uninstall drivers. Welcome to Windows. I love it, I promise. Okay, next step. Now hopefully your laptop is a little less saturated. Now we're working in the sRGB color space. Now it's time to talk about calibration. You've seen these crazy looking calibrators things that you stick on the displays and it does the fancy things. Well, we're gonna tell you how to do that. This is the Spider 5 Express. It's actually on the cheaper side. I think we pay like 120 or something. We're gonna tell you about a free software to use that's DisplayCal. And then you can just pick up a used calibrator to use, because really the price differences are just about the software that's included, but you can use DisplayCal for free. And again, all these things are in the description below. Why this was so important for me to figure out is because I am on so many different computers all the time. So my main go-to when traveling or just out and about is my Dell XPS 159570. I also use this when I'm editing at my apartment, which I need to find a desktop solution for my apartment, because like editing 50% of my videos on a laptop when I'm like a professional video maker is kind of like lame. And then we have my lovely PC tower here with the LG Ultrawide, which is the least color accurate of all of my displays. We have another LG monitor over here. My assistant editor uses the Razer Blade 15 for his go-to. So the goal is to have all of these things working together, working on the same level. So when I get sent a project from the Razer Blade and I see, oh, the color is super magenta, what is up with this? And I change it. And then I send that to another person as a YouTube link and the color's all messed up there. You're just editing around in circles and not making good colors. Sentences are hard to say sometimes. Feel free to use the bundled software that comes with these things, or you can go all out and get the X-Rite Pro i1 or something. That's the one you can do within Dell Premiere Color app. So let's go through the steps. DisplayCal 3, here we go. Go to the website and download DisplayCal 3. You can go through the initial setup. For most users, the defaults DisplayCal has pre-checked will work fine. Navigate to the top to the tools menu. Hover over instrument and instrument install Argyle CMS instrument drivers. Argyle? Then plug in that colorimeter. Here we go, guys. So again, go to Tools, this time to Corrections, then Import Profile Corrections from another display profiling software. In those calibration settings, let's set our white point to 6500K instead of letting our colorimeter measure the white balance of our space. 6500K is what most screens use as their white point, so just use that. If you're a photographer and hey, you're printing out your work in this place that we call the world and you're physically giving people things, I think it's more around 6000K. So you can just Google it, but yeah, it's a little bit lower. Printing, can't imagine. And that's it. So let calibrate and profile, place your colorimeter over the crosshairs. It'll show on your screen and ensure there is no space between the device and the screen. It helps to tilt the screen back a little bit to get more of a snug fit. And you're off. You're calibrating your screen. If that didn't take enough time, this will probably take another hour. So go watch some more Saradietschy YouTube videos, youtube.com/saradietschy. If this video has helped you, make sure to smash that subscribe button. I'm almost at 500K. Hey, woo! Printing the money, is that what we're doing? So we've made it, we did it together. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below and maybe the Peachy Fam, we can join together as a smart collective and help the people out if they have questions down below. Make sure to keep your color calibrator around because it's actually normal to recalibrate your screen, I would say every 6 months or so. I hope this helped out not only you XPS users, but the people out there, if you have a razor blade, if you have these laptops that are putting in beautiful 4K displays, what's the point if it's not color accurate? So I think this is a very important step to take because the displays that we're seeing in laptops are amazing. That's why I switched to a Windows laptop. But seriously, I love the display options we have and touch display, I like it a lot. 4K touch display, wow. And for the context of this video, this is primarily if you're working in the sRGB color space. You know, I'm delivering everything I have, people are viewing my content via the internet. So that's what I'm most concerned with. These $1,000 LG displays or my laptop display, that's enough. But if you're a color purist and you want to get into proper color, you're making maybe for the bigger screens, that's when those external displays come in handy. They're going to be a hefty price tag, 10K, 20K, 30K, but that's when you get into color spaces like BT2020 and you're concerned about HDR, you're concerned about all these other things. You need a wider range of color. And when the color space is this big, sRGB is like, you know, it's like right here. So that's what this video is for. Of course, I'm super excited for the Apple XDR to get in people's hands to really see how color accurate it is, because it probably hits a market of people who don't want to spend those, $30,000 on those displays, even though those displays are actually, yes, way more color accurate. But hey, that's a rabbit hole for another video, right? Thank you so much for tuning in. Let me know if you like this video. Hit that subscribe button down below for new videos every single week. I got a lot of fun ones coming up. Subscribe, have I already said that? Okay, you're probably bored at this point. Amazing if you made it to this point. Stay peachy. Okay, bye.